Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about that module number 2, that is distance protection. Here we are going to discuss about that introduction of that distance protection. So let us discuss about that introduction of a distance protection. Distance protection is nothing but an widely used protective scheme for protection of especially like high and extra high voltage transmission and sub-transmission lines. As earlier topics, we have seen about the different types of overcurrent protection schemes, and now we are going to discuss about the distance protection. So distance protection is widely used for extra high voltage and for transmission and for the sub-transmission lines. But this scheme implies a number of distance relays which measure that impedance or some components of line impedance at the relay location, because earlier we are used the different types of overcurrent relays where we are used like electromagnetic type overcurrent relay and also static overcurrent relays and numerical overcurrent relays and different types of numerical overcurrent relays like microprocessor based, microcontroller based, DSP based, field programmable gate array type and artificial neural networks types of numerical relays, numerical overcurrent relays, what we are seen in our earlier discussion. But now why we are shift instead of like overcurrent protection to the distance protection, that is because of in case of an overcurrent protection, what we discussed in our earlier topics, either static overcurrent relays or numerical overcurrent relays. For example, if you take that static overcurrent relays, where we are using that different types of overcurrent relays like IDMT, definite time, inverse time. So all these relays, there are some cases where we are using like level 1 detector, level 2 detector, and again time settings, we are going to use some timing circuits for the function of level detector 1 and level detector 2, because to overcome the problems especially like transients, aggressive currents, harmonics. So to overcome this difficulty where the system becomes so complicated, because instead of using like one transformer, again it is converting alternating currents into direct currents, and direct currents again is converted into ones and zeros to make into digital quantities through data acquisition systems, and again that data we are compared with that level detector 1 where we have that preset value, and again level detector 2, in between level detector 1 and level detector 2 again we are using one time delay circuits like RC circuits and RL circuits, how we are using, and again level detector 3. So where the system becomes so complicated when we are going to compare with so many number of times with the level detectors, with the existing fault actuating quantities like voltage, current and power through phase angle, where we are not satisfied with the better operation. So that's why now we are going to switch over that one more topic called as distance protection, where the fault location and the relay location in between we are going to calculate that actual quantities of the line parameters like voltage, current, power, impedance, reactance, admittance. With help of these values we are going to conclude that whether fault happened or not, or it's because of like transients or other fault conditions. So this scheme actually implies a number of distance relays which measure that impedance or some components of the line impedance at the relay location. Some components of the line impedance means sometimes we can take that only pure reactance or pure resistance or both real and imaginary values. Okay, we are going to calculate from the fault location towards that relay location. So from fault location towards that relay location, if you are going to calculate that line parameters like line impedance, line admittance, line susceptance, so based upon all these values we are going to conclude that whether the fault happened or it's because of the transient. So compared to that previous relays like overcurrent relays, now we are going to compare with the distance protection. Distance protection is going to better operation, a better performance compared to the overcurrent relays, because in case of a distance protection where we are going to calculating the line parameters, through the line parameters we are going to conclude that whether it is a fault or it's because of transient. So it is So it is giving that better results compared to the over current relay, what we discussed in your earlier discussion, like static over current relays, electromagnetic type over current relays, and numerical over current relays. Compared to all those three types of the relays, now compare with the distance relays. Distance relays gives that better operation, and that too it is applicable for the applications like extra high voltage applications and transmission line applications and sub-transmission line applications. Anyhow, we are calculating the line parameters like voltage, current. For example, the measured quantity is proportional to the line length. For example, as we know that the formula capital R is equal rho L by A. So the resistivity of the given material depends upon that the resistance of the given conductor or the resistance of the given conductor per set depends upon the resistivity of the material of the conductor and also the length of the transmission line and area of the cross section. For example, the resistance of the transmission line depends upon the resistivity of the material which was used to manufacture of that particular transmission line, either ACSR conductor or AAC conductor or AAAC conductor, and also the line resistance has been increases, its length of the transmission line increases, and the resistance of the transmission line may get decreases based upon the area of cross section. If the area of cross section of the conductor is increases, then resistance will get decreases. If the length of the transmission line is increases, then the resistance of the transmission line is going to increases. Therefore, in case of an distance protection where we are going to calculate that line parameters like line voltage, current, line impedance, line reactance, line susceptance and line admittance. Therefore, the measured quantity is proportional to the line length as the formula just now what we discussed, like R is equal to rho L by A. So this is this kind of calculation where we are doing means between that location of the relay and the point where the fault has been occurred. Therefore, as the measured quantity is proportional to the distance along the line, the measuring relay is called as simply called as a distance relay. Modern distance relays provides high speed fault clearance. They are used where overcurrent relays become slow and there is difficulty in grading time overcurrent relays for complicated networks. Especially for complicated networks, it is difficult to identify that which kind of overcurrent relay is suitable for that particular application. Whenever we are going and making some confusion during that case where we can use this simple relay which is called as distance relay. Therefore, the modern distance relays are used for protection of transmission lines and sub-transmission lines at different operating voltages like 220 kV transmission line, 132 kV transmission line, 66 kV transmission line, and in 33 kV transmission line also we can use this kind of modern distance relays. Sometimes they can also use at 11 kV, and also for example like 132 kV and 220 kV systems, the recent trend is to use carrier current protection, and the relaying units used in carrier current protection are distance relays. So carrier current protection is nothing but one type of the protection where we are carrying the information through the transmission line, like the line impedance, line admittance or line reactance, with help of our line susceptance. With help of all these values, we are going to compare that preset value. The preset value has been compared with the line impedance, line reactance, line admittance and line susceptance. These values, I mean the line parameters, has been calculated between fault location and the relay location. The distance relays operate under the control of carrier signals, and also in case of failure of carrier signal, they can act as a backup protection and we can use that pilot protection. As distance protection scheme is non-unit system of protection, because throughout the transmission line, wherever the fault happened, we can use this kind of non-unit system of protection like distance protection. A single scheme provides both primary and backup protection. And the most important versatile family of relays in the distance relay group is, these are the various types of the relays what we are going to use in case of a distance protection. That is, the first relay is called as an impedance relay, then second relay is called as reactance relay, and third relay is called as Mohr relay, and fourth relay is called as angle impedance relay, and fifth relay is called as quadrilateral relays, and sixth relays are called elliptical and other conic section relays. So these are the different types of distance relays protection what we are going to use for suppose as to make that individual protection scheme and to give that better operation whenever that overcurrent relays may become slow down and it is complicated to use. We can use the distance protection. Thank you.